Alright, so we're back again with the Pixel to Things boards, and today I'm really excited because I'm going to show you how to sequence these in xLights because it's super, super easy. We saw last time when I went over the Pixel to AC board how easy it is to control AC lights, dimmable AC lights, with nothing more than the data from a Pixel. Here I am in the test mode for Falcon, and immediately I just plug in the Pixel line and I have dimmable AC channels. It does not get easier than that. But let's dive in to xLights and see how we model this so you can sequence it with your show.
So let's dive into xLights. So first, in my test setup, I have 5 pixels that come off of my controller before the Pixel 2 Things board. So I'm gonna just put 5 pixels here. I'm just gonna call this 5 pixels start. And these just represent those 5 pixel nodes that are coming directly off of the Falcon. Okay. So next we need to model the Pixel 2 Things board. The first way we're going to model this is with what's called a channel block. And it's this one that has 2 rectangles in the model. So we're going to create a new channel block. We're going to drag that over. And by default, it has 16 channels. So we're gonna name this Pixel2AC, and we're gonna say this is 9 channels, because that's what we have, and we're pretty much done. We can go in and sequence this with channel 1, channel 2, channel 3, channel 4. But there's some really cool things about channel block that allow you to sequence it like a pixel, even though it's using AC lights. So for instance, right now you can see that there's channels 1 through 9 here, and it asks for a color. Now these colors don't actually mean anything to the output like it would with a pixel, but what it does do is, in the sequencing, allows you to sequence that as if it's a specific color. So I'm going to just do some quick renaming of these colors, and what this is going to allow us to do is, on the Pixel 2AC model as a whole, I can ramp different colors, and all of the red channels will ramp together, all of the green channels will ramp together, and all of the blue channels will ramp together. So let's just show a quick example of that. So I'm going to first create a new sequence. And we have our Pixel 2AC model, and we have our 5 pixel start model, and I am just going to move that up to the top just so it's obvious. And then if you double click Pixel 2AC, there we have all of our strands. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put a single strand effect on 5 pixel start, and I'm going to copy that to the Pixel 2AC. Real quick, let's just show this off here. So we have red going through, we have green going through, and blue. Now you can, of course, come in here and just do a solid color on red, and you can make that vary in intensity, and that's going to up the brightness. But since this is on the top level, since we're just doing a red ramp, it only affects the red channel, only affects the green channel, or only affects the blue channel, depending on the selected color. But we can make this a lot cooler and neater. Rather than just dots, you can actually add in pictures. And this was a really cool addition. So if you hover over this little reindeer icon, you can see it says create new image. And you can draw anything that you have a picture of. So I'm going to add some red lights. What you can do is set the start channel of this to be the first channel of Pixel2AC, which is really neat. So if I come here and say, this is going to be the start of the Pixel2AC model on channel one. So if you look up here, Pixel2AC starts on channel 16. Red lights is also on channel 16. Now, if I change the green lights to say, I want to start at the model of the red, Pixel2AC, but I want to start on channel 2, you can see that green lights is now on channel 17. And then the blue lights, we'll change that to start of the Pixel2AC model, but that's going to be on channel 3. And now the blue lights are on channel 18. Okay, so if I come back here and I add those new elements in to my sequence, I have red, green, blue. Take these red, green, and blue channels and we apply the on effect to, for instance, the red channel, or to the red lights. You can see the first channel of the Pixel2AC is also lighting up because this one is lighting up. Now I've used a white color here because just like on the channel block where we've applied colors, you can also apply colors to these images. So by default, the image, or excuse me, the color for these is white, but if you come to the string color, the string properties, you can change this just like the other channel block. And those will respond to those colors. So we can have our red lights ramp, we can have our green lights ramp, and our blue. Super easy, right? Cool. So that's it.